If you sanctify today, you will see miracle tomorrow, the Lord said. So, the miracle is the second stage. First stage is being healed, being cleansed. Come, eat and drink of the bread and wine that I have prepared. Give up your foolishness and take the straight path of discernment. People in the world, they move as though the life is theirs as they wish, and they have become foolish. Take time to discern your ways. Where are you going? How are you living? And eat what your God has prepared for you, and you will live a glorious life. If we read from the book of Ephesians chapter 5, verse 15 onwards, where the word of God says, pay attention, my dear children, how you behave. Do not live as the unwise, but as responsible persons. Try to make use, good use of the present time, because these days are evil. Jesus says, if you live through me, you will have my life. There is life in the Father, and I live through the Father. If you live through me, the same life which I have received from the Father will flow to you. Ask the Lord to take your family deep into the life of prayer. Even if your husband, your wife doesn't like you, your children are sleeping, take the sleeping children, put them under your may the prayer, may the tears that you shed will come upon you. I remember one small incident in my life. One day I saw my father and my mother, they had a particular problem. I don't know what is the problem. They were praying, holding the hands. Suddenly I was sleeping there. Suddenly I saw my father. My father means I love him so much. He loves me so much. And I saw, how can my father, who is mine, can hold the hands of my mother? So I want to pull his hand and catch me. But what did my father do? With one hand, he took me close to me, close to him. But he never left the hand of my mother. And I saw the tears falling. Soon I took, got up. I do not know what they were praying, but I remember I sat with them. I was also crying with them. Yes, prayer is contagious. Prayer will open the heaven for you. Prayer is the depth sea. There you will find deep pearls, costly fishes, what you will never get outside the world, you will get through your prayer. Your family should go deep into the prayer life. The more it spends time in prayer, the more the family's issues will be settled. The more the light that is needed for your family, the grace that is needed for your family, the blessing and answers that are needed for your family will be given to you. The moment you, along with your family, start to pray together, start to kneel together, may God grant us, lead us into the depth of life of prayer. Let my life enter into the depth of prayer. When I and my family pray together, you will reveal to me the things which we never know. It is there you give the revelation how our families have to go through the problems. It is only when we pray together, when we pray individually, and when we pray together as a family, You reveal the secrets. When I and my family become a wall between God and the people. The book of Revelation, chapter 22, verse 11. He who sins, let him sin more and more. He who is doing all kind of evil things, let him do. But you, my children, you who are called to be holy, become holier and holy. Because your holiness is your power. Your holiness is the power that will dispel every darkness. Your holiness is the power that will protect you from every evil. No one can come to the Lord without holiness. It is your holiness that will protect you. It is your holiness that will safeguard your family members. You do not know where are your family, what are the problems they are going through. Daniel chapter 1 verse 8. Daniel, he determined himself that he will never allow the dirt of the world to dirtify his life. He will never drink that alcohol, that type of food, whereby his body will be defiled. He determined, not decided, not wished, he determined. Yes, you hold on to holiness. You not merely desire holiness, you dip yourself into holiness. Become holy. Go deep into the depth of holiness. Throw your life, the net, into the depth of holiness. There you will find great pearls for your life. It is there your life will receive great riches and honor and glory. There is nothing in the world than the gift of holiness. Commit your life. The second coming of the Lord is very near. On that day, not for those who are working for God, not even those who are preaching the word of God, but those who have purified themselves with the blood of the Lamb, they will be taken away. Not anybody and everybody. If you don't purify yourself, if you don't grow in holiness, when the Lord comes on the sky, you will be left out. It will be a horrible thing. You will cry over, oh, I worked for God. Oh, I preached the word of God. Oh, I did lot of sacrifice to God. But you did not make yourself holy. The Lord says, I, the Lord, is holy. And I want you to be holy. Hallelujah.
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 Oh, holy God, make me holy like you. Your holiness is your power. There may be many, many difficulties, many issues in your life. Commit your life to make yourself holy. The book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 15. If you make yourself holy today, go to the altar and cry for you and for your family. Lord, spare your people, Lord. Lord, spare my family, Lord. Cry for your husband. Cry for the holiness of your wife. Cry for the holiness of your children. And the power of the Lord will begin to operate in your family.